Good morning to all. Last class we discussed about application of first law of thermodynamics for flow process, steady flow energy equation. So based on the steady flow energy equation, we solve some simple problems. The first problem, in a steam plant, 1 kg of water per second is supplied to the boiler. 1 kg of water per second is supplied to the boiler. The enthalpy and velocity of water entering the boiler are the initial velocity. Mass is, they mentioned 1 kg per second. The initial enthalpy and velocity of the boiler, whatever the water is entering, is 8800 kilojoules per kg and 5 meter per second. Next, the water receives 2200 kilojoules per kg of heat in the boiler at constant pressure. So whatever the water, it is receiving the heat, 2200 kilojoules of heat. Receiving means we are supplying heat, it's a positive, at constant pressure. Next, the steam after passing through the turbine, boiler exit they are not provided. They provided boiler inlet. Next, turbine exit. Turbine come out with the velocity. Turbine exit velocity of the steam is 50 meter per second and its enthalpy is 2500 kilojoules per kg. So boiler inlet condition they given, turbine outlet condition. Next, the inlet is 4 meters above the turbine exit. The inlet is 4 meters above the turbine exit. Assuming the heat loss from the boiler and the turbine to the surrounding are 20 kilojoules per kg. Assume the heat loss from the boiler and turbine combinedly, boiler and turbine combinedly, total heat loss they given. Heat supply to the boiler already given 2200 kilojoules per kg. Second, heat loss combinedly boiler and turbine is 20 kilojoules per kg. Calculate the power developed by the turbine. Next, one more assumptions they given. Consider the boiler and turbine as single system. If they are not given the assumptions, first I want to calculate the boiler exit conditions. Then turbine inlet conditions is same. Then same we can use for turbine inlet and also again turbine outlet conditions. Based on that, I want to calculate the total work done by the boiler. But here they given direct condition, boiler and turbine as a single unit. They considered boiler and turbine as a single unit. Then simply note down the given data. Mass flow rate of the steam 1 kg per second. Enthalpy of water inlet H1 equal to 800 kilojoules per kg. Velocity of water inlet C1 equal to 50 meter per second. Heat input 2200 kilojoules per kg. Turbine outlet velocity 10 meter per second. Enthalpy of steam outlet 2520 kilojoules per kg. Head difference 4 meters. The head difference is 4 meters. Next, heat loss from the boiler and turbine is 20 kilojoules per kg. Apply the steady flow energy equation. First, any problem, write first basic steady flow energy equation and substitute the parameters. H1 minus H, I want to determine the work. So you came inlet with mass some energy is entering and with mass some energy is leaving. So net mass, net with mass, net energy inlet H1 minus H2 plus C1 square by minus C2 square by 2 or Z1 minus Z2 into G plus Q in also is there 2200 and heat loss also is there. Loss means minus is 20 equal to W. Then, but while we are calculating, we want to consider one point. This velocity they given in meters. Head is given in meters, not kilometers. But enthalpy is given kilojoules. So first we want to convert the kinetic and potential energy in kilojoules. Otherwise, work done by the system, it will not come. Work upon the system value, it will come. So divide by 1000, it will come in kilojoules, kinetic energy. Potential energy also divided by 1000. Automatically, it will come in. If we are the key point in the calculation, this point we want to note. Always we want to convert the kinetic energy and potential energy. Why? Because velocity always they are giving in meters, not kilometers. Head also they are giving in meters, not kilometers. So divide by 1000, then we calculate the net work done, we will get positive. Turbine means positive. If it is not coming positive, somewhere we did the calculation in wrong direction. Especially we are mistaking in the one area, the kinetic energy and potential energy must be in joules. It is coming first, you convert into kilojoules. Why? Because enthalpy in kilojoules, heat in kilojoules, work in kilojoules, then work done equal to 458.80 kilojoules per kg. Okay, it's a simple problem. Only one units and dimensions are major driving force. Only one equation you apply, known parameters you substitute and determine the unknown parameter. That equation also you don't want to mug up. Just with mass, some energy is coming, heat we are supplying. This is the total energy in, and we are assumed to work W, and with mass, some energy is leaving. It's open system, energy in equal to energy out. And coming to the second problem, in a gas turbine unit, gas flows through the turbine is 15 kg per second. Gas flows through the turbine is 15 kg per second. Sorry. And the power developed by the turbine is 12,000 kilowatt. The enthalpy of gas at inlet and outlet is 1260 kilojoules and 400 kilojoules respectively. And velocity of the gas at inlet and outlet are 50 meter per second and 1100 meter per second respectively. Calculate the rate at which heat is rejected to the turbine. Next, second question, the area of the inlet pipe gives the specific volume of the gas at the inlet is 0.545 meter cube per kg. Here I want to determine two things. One is area of the inlet pipe. Second one is heat rejected, means we will get the negative value to the turbine. In this, they provided mass flow rate 15 kg per second. And what is the power developed by the turbine also they given. 1200 kilowatt, sorry, 12,000 kilowatt work done by the turbine they given, and enthalpy in and enthalpy out they provided, and velocity in and velocity out they provided. But they are not given any head, means the turbine is horizontal, one assumption, there is no head difference. So same, what are the parameters they provided? Enthalpy of gas at inlet, enthalpy of gas at outlet, velocity of gas at inlet, velocity of gas at outlet, power developed the turbine 12,000 kilowatt, gas or mass flow rate of the 15 kg per second. Then Q equal to work done, right? Plus here heat interaction I want to calculate. Then this mass, with mass whatever the energy is in is taking place, come this side. Q equal to work done plus M into H2 minus H1 plus C2 square by 2 minus C1 square by 2 simply. But only one condition, kinetic energy first convert into joules to kilojoules divided by 1000. Then we can calculate what is the heat loss. Q, we got negative value. In the question itself they ask loss, automatically it will come negative only. So we are in right direction. Minus 828 kilowatt. Move to the area. Mass into specific volume equal to velocity into area. So mass they given in mass flow rate is 15 kg per second. Specific volume at inlet, it is 0.45 equal to velocity of inlet, not exit. Why? Because I want to determine inlet area 50 meter per second, and area of the pipe I want to determine. You, if you substitute, you will get the area of the pipe is 0.135 meters. Simple problem. You can calculate, you can when you have any doubts, units and dimensions you apply. Mass kg per second, specific volume meter cube per kg, kg kg can cancel, meter cube per second, velocity meter per second, area meter square, then meter cube per second. This is totally volumetric flow rate. Basic, if you have any doubt on that, otherwise there is no issue. Move to the third question. And it is a common question everywhere we are going, puncture shop or anywhere. It's a commonly we are observing this one. An air receiver of volume 5.5 meter cube contains air at 16 bar and 42 degree centigrade. An air receiver of volume 5.5 meter cube contains air at 16 bar and 42 degree centigrade. A valve is opened and some air is allowed to blow out to the atmosphere. Once I opened the volume, valve, automatically air is allowed to blow out from the atmosphere. Then the pressure of air in the receiver dropped rapidly 12 bar. In all shops we are doing, by the compressor they are filling air in a receiver based on the pressure. If it is 5 bar is limit means 5 bar, then automatically compressor cut off. Once we are using for filling of the tires, this air automatically pressure of the receiver automatically reducing. Same problem. Drops rapidly to 12 bar. When the valve is then closed, calculate the mass of air which has left the receiver. Simple. So first we want to, before opening the valve, what is the mass of air? That one we want to calculate. Next, after open the valve, of sometime we open, then after we close the valve, then what is the mass of air is available? Because volume is fixed. The receiver volume is not changing. The open system, receiver volume is not changing, is fixed. So that volume initially and finally, the volume is same, 5.5 meter cube. Next, initial pressure is 16 bar. Initial temperature they given 42 degrees, 42 plus 27, 315 Kelvin. Then final volume also same, because the volume we are not changing, 5.5 meter cube. Then P2 equal to 15 bar. Then basic equation P1 V1 equal to MRT. What is the universal gas constant of air, R value? Universal gas constant we know, 8.314 kilojoules per kg mole Kelvin. Divide by the molecular weight. Molecular weight of the air is 28. Then you will get the value is 0.287. You substitute, determine the initial mass of air is available in receiver at 16 bar pressure. Next, I want to determine the at 12 bar pressure. Once we are opening valve, air rush out to the short duration. So generally short duration process you can assume as adiabatic. If they are provided, very good. If they are not provided, generally we are assuming adiabatic. No heat loss process. If you assume adiabatic and determine the T2 value, adiabatic process I already in last table I provided the relation between temperature and pressure also. T2 by T1 equal to P2 by P1 whole power 1 minus 1 by gamma. Then we substitute gamma of air, we all know 1.41. Then T2 is 290 Kelvin. Once I know that T2, then determine the same equation, PV equal to MRT, determine the mass after final condition, that is 79.3 kg. Then how much mass of the air is left? That is only we want to calculate. Initial mass I know 97.34. The final mass is 79.3. 18 kgs while receiver pressure dropped from 16 bar to 12 bar. 18 kgs of the air is escaped from through the valve. That's all. I think some varieties of the problems I solved. You can practice yourself. Then you will get much more idea, clear idea about the first law of thermodynamics applied for study flow process. Basic equation is same, that's all. Equation is not changing, just based on the given data we are substituting. One point we want to recall, the kinetic energy, potential energy always in joules. Why? Because velocities and head they are giving meters. So first you convert into kilojoules, divide by 1000. Then you are solving the problem, you will get in the right direction. I think next class we will discuss about the limitations and findings of the first law of thermodynamics. Thank you. Thank you very much.